Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, we will take a look at converting vector images into shapes, but our focus will be on vectors that contain multiple images, such as collections. After Effects treats vectors as a whole, disregarding masks, so you may have run into this issue in the past. No worries, I'll walk you through it. Okay, so for the last few episodes, I've shown you guys how to convert vector images into shapes. What happens, though, if you have a vector image that has multiple images? So we have 16 different images, but say we only want to animate this pill bottle. One option you might be thinking is to take our rectangle tool, mask around our pill bottle, so that way it isolates it from the rest of the collection, and then going to layer, create shapes from vector layer. But that won't work, and let me show you why. Whenever you convert vectors into shape layers, After Effects converts everything on that collection. As you can see, we have groupings for every image, and it completely disregarded where our mask was. If you hit M, we can see that a mask is still there, but it's not the mask that we wanted. It's good to know some Illustrator skills. So let's go into Illustrator. After Effects will only recognize layers that are brought over from Illustrator. So each one of these groups is a different element. But if we were to bring this in, After Effects would not recognize these individual ones. So how do you solve this? Vectors are arranged in different ways. Some vectors are very organized. This one is extremely organized, where each one of these is a different image. But I've seen vectors where the elements of the image are just everywhere, and that could take some time to organize. But if you're lucky enough to get a vector like this, what you want to do is you want to go to this group that contains all of your images, and you want to click this right here, this drop down. You want to click Release to Layers Sequence. What that does is it converts everything in this group to its own layer. And so you can even see it says layer. Then you want to grab all these layers, drag it out. And you can actually get rid of this top one here. So now each one of these are a separate layer that can be recognized by After Effects as an independent layer. So you're going to go to File, Save. We'll call this Medical Collection. And then you want to save this as an Illustrator CC file. Hit OK. Let's bring in that Illustrator collection that we just created. We want to import our collection, and you want to import it as composition, not footage. If you import it as footage, if we bring that in, and it will even ask you if you want to bring it in as footage. So if we say yes, we just have the one image, and we're right back in the same position that we were to begin with. So we want to import File, Medical Collection, Composition. It's going to bring in a composition that has all of our separated layers. It also creates this folder here that has each individual image that is on its own layer from our Illustrator file. Over here, you can actually rename these. So you could go pill, syringe, and then whenever you save this and bring it in, it will be reflected in the name instead of just these layers. For our purposes, we'll just work with these layers as we have them here. So what we wanna do is we're gonna drag that pill bottle in, and now you're gonna have to kind of move it around. As we've been doing, we want to go to Layer, Create Shape from Vector Layer. And again, this is going to create one shape layer with groups for every element of this image here. So we can get rid of our original vector. Basically, what you want to do is you want to create groups for every element of this image, so that way you can manipulate every aspect of this shape layer. So let's add a group, and it's going to add it to the very bottom. Now if we hit Group 19, we see that it's this, so we'll say Divider. Okay, now our next group is going to look like it's going to be our pill body. So 17 and 18, it looks like. This entire thing is going to be our lid. Let's add a group for lid, move it above pill body. So it's group 16 all the way up to group 6. This group right here looks like it's kind of like a reflection. So let's add group, come to the top of the lid, rename this label, and we want to drag everything into here. If you click on each group, you can see where your anchor point is. Grab our anchor point. It's way up here. So hit Y. Bring our anchor point down somewhere in the middle. For reflection, bring this somewhere in the middle. And this is mainly for animating purposes, because your anchor point dictates the way that your animations will come in whenever you manipulate things like scale or rotation. So each one of these groups, they're going to have their own transform properties, but also they're going to have their own fills. And some will even have their own strokes depending on the way that the vector has been converted. So we can change the background of this. We can change that. We can change our reflection if we wanted to something else. You have complete control over the way these things are colored. Say we go to our lid. If you'll notice up here, the fill and the stroke with that question marks, that's because you have multiple groups within the lid. Okay. And each one of these groups, again, has its own fill. So if you wanted to change each one of these ridges to a different color, you could. But say like you want to change the background. And you can also, like if you grab group 6, hold down shift, go all the way down to group 15, and say you wanted to change all of that to the same color, you can do that in one quick click. Whatever you want to do to this, you have complete control over. You could actually do some crazy animations. You could actually manipulate every ridge of this lid, for example, save it as a preset, and then bring it in as a preset for future projects. You can create more groups within it. Say, for example, you want to add a group here, and say you want to have a group within your label that contains just this pill and its reflection. We grab 1, 2, and 3. As we can see, it's our pill and the reflection. Drag it into group 5. And if you hide it, you can see that's the pill bottle and this is the background. You can always do things like you can rename it pill background. So what you might want to do, for example, is say you might want to be able to rotate this pill on this background. Whereas before, the way we had it with the label only, it would have moved the entire background. So with these shape layers, you have a lot of control depending on how you organize your shape layers and your groups. Just remember, if you want to convert this to a shape layer, you can't just mask out one section of that vector. It's going to create a shape layer that has a group for every element of that vector. It essentially ignores the mask. So just keep that in mind. Converting vector images to shapes opens a whole world of possibilities, and if done correctly, can save you a ton of time. Having some basic Illustrator skills can make a huge difference. The Creative Suite is intended to be used as a unit, and I highly recommend becoming familiar with Illustrator, Photoshop, Premiere, and Encoder, as well as honing your After Effects skills. With this collective knowledge, you'll be unstoppable as a designer. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see. Thanks, everybody, and we'll see you next time.